Hello, hello, are you lonely? I'm sorry, it's just the chemicals.
I may not know how to have sex, but man, I know how to get a chest pump.
I'm fucking cold.
It's different,
bro. You're recording now, you know that.
Yeah, I know. Alrighty, boys. I'm super grateful to have this opportunity. This is my boy, Andrew.
What's up, y'all?
I'm gonna link him down in the description, of course, all his socials, but we're shooting in an empty gym right now. So we're gonna get that nice grungy aesthetic. We're hitting pull today. I'm gonna be doing back, demolishing my lats, putting the sins of humanity on my back. Isn't that right, Andrew?
Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna
get after it tonight.
We're gonna get after it tonight. But this gym is utterly beautiful. I'm so excited to just like film shit in here. And on top of that, the pump's gonna be ridiculous. Disgusting lighting, a little bit different than Muscle Factory 2. All black. I kind of vibe with the aesthetic, man. I kind of do. But yeah, super grateful once again. I just met Andrew 30 minutes ago, and we're already.
This dude's fucking huge.
We're already kicking it up.
He's gonna show me up tonight.
I'm so small, boys. I'm gonna be honest. Yeah, we're small up here and down there. So, all right, we're gonna kill it, boys. Bro, this cable machine. Four sets till failure. Once again, screw science-based lifting. I'm gonna start off with 140. See how this feels. Probably gonna get 10 reps. Maybe 12, but we're gonna control it this time. That warm up was a little bit just too much jerky, but we'll see how this feels.
I have not dated in over a year. And I've learned more about myself than I ever would have with a woman. But this is not to say that I still don't miss it from time to time, especially my recent. However, when you are as disposable as plastic, you often have to adapt your thinking.
That shit echoes throughout the entire gym. Echoes so hard, bro. Dude, I was feeling a little bit heavier than I thought, but we were controlling it, man. We were getting that negative rep, that decentric, bro. That's where you see the real gains. That's where you see it. Come on. Yep, let's work. Let's work. Yep. Those partials, man. I'm telling you, partials is what builds the muscle, bro. It might look stupid in the gym, like you're fucking the machine, but like, dude, the partials, that's where you're getting the, you saw two, first set, super control, second set, less control, third set, kind of more control, but lighter weight. Just shocking the muscle, bro.
What is it? I'm gonna show it.
Oh, fuck.
She's a squirter.
Dude, I love chemicals. It's like, ooh, it's kind of got an aftertaste. It's like a taffy apple.
Fire.
It's like a taffy. Almost like Laffy Taffy, like they're greeny apple. That's what I'm feeling right now.
Did it just to hurt me? Well, it worked, you hurt me. And now there's nothing else I can do.
Yeah, I mean, it's just like, bro, that girl's with me when I was just playing video games nonstop and like trying to be like a straight, like that's just,
dude,
weird.
That's what I'm saying. Like my ex that I dated for 4 fucking years, like yeah. I was like, I didn't lift. I played sports for the first 2 years, so like I had something going for me. But like after that, like dude, I was literally just like into video shit, and like that's the only thing I had going for me. Like I was like 130 pounds. Doing camera shit.
Yeah.
Somehow that was attractive enough.
Just wild. I think like there was definitely like a lot of red flags myself that now I see now, but
yeah.
You're just not mature enough to realize that. You're just like, you blame everything on like, oh, she broke up with me for, when in reality, like there were like things wrong with you, you know?
No, yeah, dude, and I think that's the crazy part. So, dude, a long-term relationship, like after I got out of that, I felt like so lost. Like I was like, I don't even know who the fuck I am.
Yeah.
Didn't know what the fuck to do.
Like, because it comes a part of your identity.
It was like, it was such an attachment thing too. So then after it ended, like from then to now, it's actually crazy. Like I don't even recognize the person who I was like 2 years ago.
Make my 40 pop. No pop con, I pop pistols. Reaver my body, clothing no issue. Bitch, you look sick, you need a tissue. You drop a body, I just might bless you.
Our generation sucks at dating. I mean, at this point, we're all used to receiving our dopamine in the quickest way possible. So why wouldn't we apply this same logic to our relationships? Get to know the person quicker, hit a home run, then you can leave as quick as you got to know them.
It might be a 100-pound day. I just did that for 15. It might be a 100-pound day.
We lack communication, or are we just over communicating at this point?
Take it out on the ex, come on!
I can see a girl's whole body within 2 days of texting them, digitally. This is before we even interact, and even share the same breath.
Man, this is fucking huge.
Are we all so connected that we are now separated?
The part where we kiss.
Yeah.
So bro is gonna get, he drives a 4Runner. He has a mullet. He's gonna have the knee tat. What is it called? They say the thigh tat. And they say that's like endless sex.
I'm sorry,
it's like 4 a.m. right now, bro. I can't process it. Oh, has a dog. How many were at?
A puppy.
A puppy, right. And then he also has, he listens to country, which I'm never gonna fucking sacrifice for some pussy. But he has the he's gathering the infinity stones. He has them,
bro. That is actually crazy.
Girls really be like, you know, like they obsess about you and talk about you for like 3 months straight, and then they're just like, you know, it's like the Andy meme, you know, in like Toy Story, where I'm like, I'm done playing with this boy.
Yeah, I know.
That's like, so that's true. How I felt coming back to the semester. But like, I've grown so much. It's like always like,
yeah,
like everything happens for a reason. Like, it's just another trial and tribulation.
I got that for a reason. Like, I truly believe in that. Like, every single part of my life, like, big thing that's happened, I feel like it's, like, led me to where I am today in some kind of way.
110%.
If a monkey flirted with her, she would get with... All right, nah. I wish her the best, and I will learn each day to love myself more than I ever loved her.
And I know she never even really wanted me.
You know, pushing you to be better, and I think that's why I'm so happy that it's working out the way it's working out, because we have each other to push each other and keep elevating our content. Because before, it was just me, it was me versus myself, not like I have someone there who I want to, you know, keep one-upping, and we want to just one-up each other, and that's how it's going to be.